Hello everyone, in this video I want to discuss with you about our end semester deep learning project. What we did was we worked on Emojinator. Generally in the world 90% of the people use the messaging apps, but there is a problem in that. While if you want to send an emoji to a person, you need to search for it. It takes a lot of time. From there we developed an idea for this project. Actually what happened was, if you want to send an emoji in our app, you just need to hold the photo camera button, then it will access your front cam, and with the help of that you can able to get your own emoji. Like if I want to send a fuck off symbol, then I'll use this symbol, then the video will recognize it and it will get that emoji, and it is easy to send. And like for example a thug life symbol or whatever it is, if you want to send this kind of symbol, then you need to show this kind of symbol, then it will recognize it and it will show the emoji. There is no need to search for it. And for this project we use CNN neural networks, and with the help of that we used it, and our professor Dr. Sridhar helped us a lot. He explained the different features of it, like straightening and the activation functions and all, and with the help of all of that we are able to do this project.
Keras is a high level neural networks API which is written in Python, and Kakpolo running on top of TensorFlow, CNTK and Theon. So use Keras if you want a deep learning library that allows you for easy and exclusive prototyping, and which supports both convolutional and recurrent networks, and which runs seamlessly on CPU and GPU.
Start. The core architecture of Keras is model. So model is nothing but a way to organize layers. The simplest way of is implemented in Python 2.7 to 3.6. So the core data structure of Keras is model. So model is nothing but a way to organize layers. So the simplest type of model is sequential model. So if you wanna go for complex architecture, you should use Keras functional API. So here we can see how sequential model is built. So basically you should import sequential from Keras models, then all you have to do is stacking layers, which can be done very easily with using dot add. Then once your model is ready to process, once your model looks good, you can configure the learning process with dot configure or dot compile. So after doing that, if you need to, you can further configure your optimizer. The core principle of Keras is to make things reasonably simple. Okay, then while allowing user to take to be in fully control when they need to. So you can now iterate on your training data in batches, and then alternatively you can feed your batches to your model manually. Then evaluate the whole model in one line, or you can generate predictions on new data.
In this project, our current algorithm is based on dataset containing black and white images. So in future, our goal is to develop a code which will be able to detect the human skin, so that we will be able to generate images or emojis using skin, human skin. Basically, what this course does is, instead of identifying the gestures with white and black background, it will be able to identify gestures with human skin.
Hi guys, in this semester we worked on Emojinator. Basically, it just generates emojis based on your gestures. I was doing the coding part. It wasn't funny, but my friends had a lot of fun gathering dataset Dr. Sridhar Swaminathan helped us a lot in this project. He helped us to build the models, and my teammates also did a really great job in gathering data sets, building model, and learning understanding convolution neural networks. Overall, it was a really good experience. We worked well, very well. Verma did his job on TensorFlow, understanding TensorFlow, and working on the libraries. Saushil tried to improve our project, and he also worked on the documentation and many other aspects. Mahesh, as he described in this video, worked on Keras. So it was a good experience. My part was mainly on coding. I tried to implement TensorFlow, all other teammates' implementations, and tried to make the best out of it. Basically, what it does is I can show in this. I will show you in the video.
We worked as well as a group and tried to make the best out of it. Everyone did their job really well. Overall, it was a great experience working as a group because it's a fun project to work with the emojis and the stuff. Thank you.
Hi, this is Shiv Parvati. Me and my team had both worked on capturing image from the dataset and cropping them and converting them to RGB format. We also worked on understanding the working of the libraries.